ABS-CBN alleged violations and ways on how to regain its franchise. Let us start with the following grounds found by the Technical Working Group, which serve as basis why the Congress denied its franchise. Number 1. Dual citizenship of Chairman Emeritus Eugenio Gabi Lopez III. His citizenship was found doubtful, with his dual allegiance to America and to the Philippines by his American passport and Philippine passport, in which the Constitution requires 100% Filipino citizenship in order to have ownership and management of a mass media in the country. Number 2. Unlawful return of assets to the Lopez family after martial law. They were not able to prove that they owned all their assets or properties, just like transmitter, and it is not by the government. And they do not have the actual record in their register of deeds. Next is their violation by operating pay-per-view channel, just like the ABS-CBN TV Plus, KBO, without prior approval or permission granted by the NTC or the National Telecommunications Commission. Next is the labor practices violation, in which only 25% out of their total workers, or 2,600 plus out of the total 11,700, were only the regular workers. Last violation is their biased reporting, inappropriate program content, and political meddling. But wait, don't lose hope. Here are still the ways on how to regain or how to revive the ABS-CBN franchise. Before we proceed, don't forget to click like, subscribe, and ring that notification bell in order to stay updated for more intriguing, informative, and entertaining videos only here at Nepfinity Vlog. Number 1 is the motion for reconsideration. It was adopted under rules of the House of Representatives during its 17th Congress that member of the Congress can file motion for reconsideration. But it was later revealed on Section 40 that the member who voted only with the majority, in this case, who voted against the renewal of the ABS-CBN franchise, can file the motion for reconsideration, provided that it was filed on the day or the succeeding day after the said meeting. But so far, out of 70 legislators who voted to reject the said ABS-CBN franchise, no one seemed to withdraw or change its vote and file for a motion for reconsideration. And it gives us the second option to file another franchise application. Yet, unfortunately, this move was considered futile or useless because the same set of legislators will going to vote for another franchise application. The third way is to file a grave abuse of discretion amounting to lack or excess of jurisdiction, in which the Supreme Court will have its judicial review or question the House of Representatives' decision of rejecting the said franchise. Lastly is by People's Initiative and Referendum, in which Article 6, Section 32 of the 1987 Constitution states that to provide a system of initiative and referendum in which the people can directly propose and enact laws or approve or reject any act or law or part thereof passed by the Congress or local legislative body. In this case, Filipino people can directly pass national laws but must be signed by at least 10% of the country's total voters, in which minimum of 3% shall come in each legislative district voters. And as of 2018, our total voters population accumulates to over 61,843,750, in which the 10% that shall be needed to file a referendum is almost 6,184,375. The Commission on Elections, or COMELEC, will verify the signatures of the voters and will make a referendum to be approved by the majority.